although certainly not a military invasion like the other invasions on our list, the Christian invasion was just as influential on the culture and the language, and therefore on the literature, as the other invasions that we've talked about. In 597, Pope Gregory sent St. Augustine to Christianize the pagan Anglo-Saxons. He arrived here in Canterbury and established St. Augustine's Abbey. You can see the ruins all around me of the abbey. This is all that's left at this time. Christianity wasn't new in England when St. Augustine arrived in 597. It had arrived with some of the Roman troops in an earlier time period, but it was suppressed along with the Celtic peoples and the Celtic languages during the Anglo-Saxon invasions. The Anglo-Saxons were illiterate, so their oral literature was not recorded until St. Augustine and the other monks arrived. They were the only people who were literate. So what we see in Old English literature is a blend of pagan cultures and the newer Christian tradition. We're seeing a culture in transition. When we read something like The Dream of the Rood, it's very clear that we're reading a story written by, composed by, someone who was familiar with Christianity. The story is obviously a Christian story. However, we also see elements of the old Anglo-Saxon traditions and culture within that story. Scholars think that The Dream of the Rood was probably composed around the year 700, or somewhere in the 700s, which would have been over 100 years after St. Augustine arrived. So that certainly was time enough for the ideas and the concepts of Christianity to have spread. The story of Beowulf, on the other hand, is a bit different situation. Scholars really don't know when Beowulf was composed. It could have been as early as 521. It could have been as late as the early 1000s. We just don't know for sure. For a long time, scholars thought that the story of Beowulf was originally a pagan story, and that when the Christian monks, maybe even some of those that came over with St. Augustine, recorded it, that they added the Christian interpolations, tried to make it more of a Christian story to help spread their message. Now scholars tend to think that Beowulf may have been composed by someone who was an Anglo-Saxon, but who had been exposed to and was familiar with Christianity as well. We just don't know. Whatever the case, the arrival of Christianity had an obvious influence on the literature, an influence which spread until it was a dominant factor in the literature of the Middle Ages.